What drives international trade? Many economists have come up with different answers. It is factor endowments according to Heckscher-Ohlin theory. It is innovation and imitation according to Posner and Vernon. It is differences in opportunity cost according to Haberler. It is the availability of domestic availability and non-availability of the commodities according to Kravis. Here we have Linder's theory of trade volume and demand pattern. According to Linder, the trade is driven not by the factor endowments, as unlike visualized by the Heckscher-Ohlin theory. Here the trade is driven by the domestic demand structure of the domestic demand structure. So let's have a brief introduction about the theory propounded by Staffan B. Linder in 1961. Staffan B. Linder was studying the issues of the Heckscher-Ohlin theory of international trade and Leontief paradox. Linder has come up with his own theory on the basis of the domestic demand structure, and he was explaining the trade pattern of the nations on the basis of the domestic demand structure. The trade, according to him, preferably will take place between the two nations with similar per capita income. So the trade primarily will happen between similar identical nations with similar per capita income or similar income. This is in fact an opposite argument of Heckscher-Ohlin theory. According to Heckscher-Ohlin theory, the trade will primarily take place because of factor endowments differences. So the trade will take place between capital abundant nation and labor abundant nation. That is his focus on trade. But unlike that, Linder makes it clear that the trade will primarily take place between two identical nations. That means two developed nations or two developing nations. This is the focus of Linder in his theory of demand pattern and trade volume. So this is the theory as per the Linder's theory of trade volume and demand pattern. The trade will primarily takes place between two nations with similar income level. That means with similar per capita income level. The reason for that is demand structure will be same in those two nations. For example, for the the trade will takes place primarily with developed nations, between developed nations or between developing nations. For example, when the trade is taking place between two developed nations, the two developed nations will have the same demand structure, as they have the same income level almost. Similarly, the countries with similar income will consume similar quality products. The advanced economies will consume high quality products. Low income economies, the people of low income economies will generally consume low quality products. They will seek the price reduction for the commodities. So here the production will take place, as we know, only when it has the domestic demands. That means no production will take place only for export. So the excess production, whatever is remaining excess after consuming domestically, the products will surely be exported. So the excess production, whatever is remaining excess, will be exported. So this is the core of the theory. That means the international trade, according to Linder, is just an extension of domestic trade. Without domestic trade, there will be no international trade. That means the commodities are produced primarily to meet the domestic demand. whatever is remaining excess after meeting the domestic demand will be surely exported to the other identical other nations with identical income. So this is the theory. The trade takes place primarily between two nations with identical income level. So as I said, this theory is to address the issues of Heckscher-Ohlin theory of international trade. According to Heckscher-Ohlin theory, the trade will takes place between two dissimilar nations. That means the trade will be taking place between capital abundant nation and labor abundant nation. This is the pattern of trade according to Heckscher-Ohlin theory. So on that basis, United States will trade with India. So according to Linder's theory, the trade will takes place mostly or primarily between similar nations. That means trade between capital abundant nations or trade between labor abundant nations. This is the pattern of trade according to Linder. So why does the trade happen between two nations with similar income level? As per the theory, the trade will be primarily taking place between two nations with identical income measured by per capita income. That means almost the nations with almost same per capita level will be engaged in mutual international trade. This is the pattern of trade argued by Linder. The trade will happen between developed nations or between developing nations. That the reason for that is such nations will have similar demand structure and similar propensity to trade, propensity to export and propensity to import. So whenever the demand structure in two nations are same, the commodities produced are same, the industries existing are same, the taste will be the same. That means whenever there is excess production of the commodity, that will be surely will be exported to the other nation with same demand pattern. Then I am sure that you might be thinking of one matter, that trade currently has been taking place between two non-identical nations and between two identical nations. The trade is common between dissimilar nation or similar nation. As we know, India has been trading with United States. So you might be thinking about that. India has been trading with China as well. That means India and China are almost the same countries with same income level. So this is possible. This theory is in fact not against that. So let's look. The core of the theory is in fact more similar is the demand structure in two countries, more likely they will be engaged in international trade or in mutual trade. Thus, as per the theory, there is a provision that developed nation and developing nations are also likely to get into international trade, as both nations have both higher income people and lower income people. As you know, India has higher income people as well as lower income people. Mostly India have lower income people. Similarly, the United States have higher income people as well as lower income people. So the lower income people will have the similar demand pattern or similar taste. Higher income people will prefer high quality product normally. Lower income people will prefer normally lower quality product as they don't have the enough income to purchase high quality products. So the demand, the international trade could be happening. It is possible between two developing and developed nation. That means India and trade could happen between India and United States, as the income distribution in both nations are not equal. So inequality is there. there will be high income people and lower income people as in India and the United States as well. So this is in fact due to overlapping of demand in both nations. So overlapping of demand is possible. So on that basis, let's look how international trade takes place between developing nation and developed nation. The horizontal axis of the diagram is measuring per capita income of the nations. A vertical axis measures the products, two products, Q1 and Q0. Q1 is a high quality product, Q0 is a low quality product comparatively. Y0 is the lower level of income, Y1 is the higher level of income comparatively. So there are two nations as well, country A and country B. Country A is developed nation. Its per capita income level for the moment is Y1, its higher level of income. So country A is a developed country. That will be mostly capital abundant nation as well. Country B is a lower income country with lower level of income comparatively, that is Y0, less than, it is well below Y1. So the 45 degree line OP shows the relation between the commodity and level of income, the purchasing of the commodity and level of income. Higher level of high income, that means high quality products will be mostly consumed. Lower level of income shows low quality products will be purchased. That means at Y1 level of income, the people of country A will purchase Q1 level of high quality product. Similarly, the country B at Y0 level of income will purchase Q0 level of product. That means the quality of the product being consumed is determined by the level of per capita income. But the trade is possible between these two nations, these two developed and developing nations, as the income distribution in country A and income distribution in country B are not equal. Even the income distribution is not equal in country A as well as in country B. That means inequality exists in both nations, country A and country B. So that means both nations have high income people and low income people. For example, the country A is a higher income country. Mostly the people are high income people, but since there is income inequality is existing, low income people are also there in the high income country of A. The low income people will prefer a low quality product, so they will purchase Q0. Q0 is a low quality product, so they will purchase Q0 the type of commodities. So they will the import then will takes place from the low income country to the high income country. Similarly, in country B, mostly the people are low income people, but due to the prevalence of income inequality, high income people are also there. For example, when we consider the nation of India, there are so many people living below poverty line, and there are so many people who are called super rich persons in India. They are high income people. So both nations have both high income people and low income people. So the high income people of country B is a low income country, but there are some high income group. So the high income group of low income country B will consume the high quality product of Q1. So import will takes place from high income country to low income country. But this is possible, this is materialized only when there are some kind of the similarity is there. Similarity is in terms of demand structure. Taste will be same for the high income people and for the low income people, and both nations have both high income and low income people as well. So the trade could be possible even as per the Linder's theory of trade volume and demand pattern. Here you can see BC is the combined demand of country B. That means combined demand means the low income people will consume Q0 commodity, and high income people will consume a portion of Q1 quantity of the Q1 type of high quality commodity. So the combined demand is BC is the combined demand, and moving to the high income country, AN is the combined demand of high income country A, as there exists both low income people and high income people. Mostly there will be high income people and there will be low income people as well, even in the high income country. So the low income people, low income group will prefer, will consume the low quality product of Q0. So the combined demand suppose is AN. That means in this demand pattern, BRND is the overlapping demand. That means there will be a similar demand structure for these two nations. So the trade is possible when demand structure is same in both nations. So it doesn't mean that the trade is not possible between developing and developed nation. The trade is possible between developed nation and developing nation when there exists some kind of similarity in demand structure. So ultimately the trade is driven by the domestic demand pattern. So whenever the two nations have the similar demand pattern, the trade could be possible easily. So this is the core of the theory. Trade basically happens between two similar nations with similar income, but the demand, whenever the demand structure is same in both nations, the trade could be possible. Higher the similarity of demand structure in two nations, more likely the trade will happen. This is the Linder's theory of trade volume and demand pattern. Thank you.